probably look bad.
I don't even. Well, I comb my hair. It just looks. And I got hot and sweaty. You ready, podcast?
Me looking beautiful.
Always. Mm-hmm. Hello, welcome to Straw Family Farm. I'm Christy.
I'm me.
Yeah. You're me. In the chapel, Matthew 5:9. In honor of Memorial Day, blessed are the peacekeepers, for they shall be called the children of God. Correct? And we want to thank all the peacekeepers and military that try to keep peace around the world. And he's eating me with a dinosaur. That's not being a peacekeeper. Train your dinosaur.
Dinosaur.
Tyrannosaurus Rex. So, anyway, thank you to all who served. Past, present, future. We're definitely a military-supported family and love it. Matter of fact, had a veteran out yesterday. Had a wonderful visit with him. Alright. Don't look at our hair and our faces, but hey. Right? Alright, what do we got going on in the barn stalls? Durf has hurt his leg again. We've decided he and Murphy are going to the vet. What for?
Get castrated.
Yep. They're going to be castrated. Murphy has decided that he likes to, yes, son. You're trying to be, just put him over your head so that you are the dinosaur in the video. See? No. Look. Okay, so. All right. Me and a dinosaur is now podcasting. Fine, keep it on your face.
I like my dinosaur my hat better.
Okay. Anyway, Murphy has gone to biting Ginger and actually getting rough with her. So
me and a dinosaur are podcasting.
Are you gonna tell about in the barn stalls?
Oh, waste it.
Sorry. Well, Moose will have a gummy. Will he eat a gummy?
I don't know.
Anyway, okay, so.
She wasted a gummy.
Come on, in the barn stalls.
Kittens are doing good.
Yep. Durf has cut his leg again.
Yep.
Being silly, so he's going to go and be cut. If he can't behave himself and act like a decent horse, and he can when he's under saddle. He does not go after the girls. He's well behaved. We can't keep him well behaved when we're not there to. And it'll come with age. But I don't know if he's going to live through that. You know what I mean? Because the last one he got was pretty nasty. He's being doctored morning and night now. Right?
Yep.
Okay. So, there's that. And then Dunny, the outside horse. His name is Outlaw, isn't it?
No, it's Fred.
It's Fred. Okay. So, Fred. That's my eye. Probably sweat her hair.
Fred decided he didn't like the water here.
I guess. But, Doc thinks he's got what?
Ulcers.
Yeah. So, he's on ulcer medication. And we got him to go back to drinking, correct? Yeah. Mm-hmm. The first thing they did was give him a shot of a steroid that will control pain, correct?
Yep.
That made him go back to drinking, which means that it's masking pain someplace, which pretty much narrows down the field. They did a panel of blood work on him, right?
Yep.
To rule out what stuff, do you remember?
No. Rule out stuff.
Worminess. They did a fecal. Right?
Yeah.
They did all kinds of stuff. And what it came down to was two different things, right? Ulcer or what was the other? If this didn't work, you had to do what?
Taking back, they said.
Yeah. Anyway, this is the first step, is to figure out what's going on with him. And so, it's nasty here. You want your dead dinosaur? Anyway.
Moose won't even eat it. That's bad.
I wouldn't eat those. They kind of look nasty.
Try one. They're good. Yeah, try one.
Come are on. You going to podcast while I eat it? You going to talk?
Yeah, I'll talk.
Okay. Finish telling them what's in the barn sauce and tell me which one you want me to try.
Okay. A bunch of stuff is happening in the barn sauce.
No, you can't do that. You got to tell me first which one you want me to try. And then...
Hang on, I got to figure out which one I have more of.
Well, this one's the same as that one.
No, it's not. This one's the same as these three up here. See, they have ridges down the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This one goes over. Okay. So I want 7 of those, or 4 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No. All right. I want you to eat that one.
Okay. So you have to tell about in the barn still to finish the story with Denny and anything else that's going on. You got to tell about Murphy.
And do you know if you like those?
Steer. I've never had them.
Oh, okay.
What are they?
Dinosaurs.
Okay, so he was at the grocery store the other day, and they had a whole line of those Hasbro things, and this is Hasbro dinosaurs. I'm just hoping that they're not sour and taste gross. You guys will see me spit something out on camera. Okay, so you tell about Murphy's antics and him in with the bear.
Well, put Murphy in the bear last night.
Why?
Because he keeps pointing them out, Ginger, and Ginger doesn't want them out, so they're fighting all the time.
He's biting her neck.
Yeah, he's biting her neck. So,
we need to separate him.
Yep, we need to separate him, so we took him, put him in with bear, thinking they'd get along.
Bears? Who?
The big steer.
Big longhorn.
Yeah.
Big horn. Hottest thing here on the place, isn't he?
Yep, Murphy pissed him off.
And we are not sure how.
So, we had to move him out. Bear was chasing Murphy around.
Bear was chasing him like he got his horns down and was flicking dirt. And it was kind of funny. Ooh, I don't like the blue part. The red part wasn't bad, but the blue part, that doesn't even taste natural.
Try this one.
No. I'm done.
Oh, okay.
I got one down. You were supposed to keep talking, and I had to talk anyway.
It's still funny to see your face. Alright, so he made him mad, so he's taking the equipment pin tonight.
Like, what's going after him? And Murphy's a miniature donkey, and he's what? 1,200 pounds of beef on the hoof. And he's got these big old long horns, because he's a longhorn. And like, he was rubbing him on the ground, and then doing his leg. I don't know what Murphy did, but whoo! And then RJ had to get him backed off and get Murphy out of there. So, we've just come to the conclusion that Murphy's going to get what?
Cut.
Yep. It's going to be gelded. Take that little thinker away. So, he won't be able to think with it anymore. Anything else going on? We're finished this year. We've got 3 more to shear and then some in the man pen, right?
7 total.
7 total. So, just a few a night, and we should be done in, what, 2 nights?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I think that's about it. Well, we've still got hooves that we've got to do. Baby girl has one hoof that gets really long. It's got to be done. Reba has got 2 that get really long. I think Big Mama's got 1. So, we're going to have to line them up, and I think we're going to do that today, because it's really got to be done, and I've been saying it for how long?
Wow.
And we need to warm them. So I'm thinking we're going to do that. It's RJ and I's job. We're both home today, so that's what we're going to do, I think, is work the sheep and goats, right?
Yep.
So, and then any that aren't sheared can be done when we shear them. But that'll get all of them. And then there's a gland we have to check on. Is it mean or fuzzy? One of the new merinos, we're supposed to check the little gland, make sure it doesn't get all clogged up. But we'll do that when we shear. There are 2 of the ones left. Those 2 and Hershey are left. So, all right. Mending fences. What do we have to fix this week?
Water hydrant.
And? Okay, so.
I suppose I had to scrap the old one and replace it.
No, the alternator.
Oh.
You what? Pulled off the alternator.
Yep.
You drove it what? You got two small little trips out of it, Yep. It went to flash in the battery sign, and then the alternator went. Which I thought the low voltage was probably the alternator anyway, and I asked him several times, but nobody would get it checked. So anyway, we'll see how it runs. We'll get it replaced and see how Nelly does. Anything else in mending fences? You had to go help somebody else get their lawnmower going, right?
Yep.
Right now I gotta go out and jump start my lawnmower. I was using it and then all of a sudden it died. So, well, it didn't die. I got off to
it didn't.
And then it just wouldn't. No, it didn't make any noise. I turned it off, got off, opened the
it
gate.
It made noises, it would be running.
I know. Got on it, went to start it. Click, click, click. That's it. So, I'm guessing it might need a new battery. Alright. Anything else?
I need a new phone.
Yeah. Don't have it replaced yet, though. And that just happened yesterday, so.
Yeah.
In the yarn farm. What are you doing?
Ooh. 35% done.
Uh-huh. You're reading text on the podcast. Wonderful. In the yarn farm, shearing, we already talked about that, right? In the field. Man, everything is growing. We got a lot of rain. And so this year the garden is really doing well. Except for the stuff that the goats have eaten down. Knock on wood, I haven't lost any plants. Only the goat-eaten ones, right? I've got snake gourds, loofahs. I thought I had some watermelon, but I don't know. The zucchini. The bell peppers are back. The goats ate them off, ate the tops off, but they're back. That's actually sign language for deer if you don't stick your hand up. We're deer.
You know what that sign language for?
I have no clue.
I'm awesome.
Attitude. That's what it's got. Anyway, so I'm going to do an update later this week on it because it's really looking good. The herbs are back. That's where I was mowing at. I've got to finish mowing and weeding up. The grass had grown. The Johnson grass is really all that's tall, isn't it, son?
Mm-hmm.
So, I'll get that done this week, and we're going to try and get back to podcasting, to posting two other videos a week. It's just been an off week, but, RJ's going to try and post on Tuesday and Thursday plus the podcast, so. Right?
Right. What did I just agree to again?
Video. Tuesday and Thursday, like normal. Back to doing what you got to do. In the farmhouse.
Yeah. Oh my God. I have them all lined up.
Hey, I was getting them. There it is.
Look, right now they're all even.
Not color wise.
Oh, you're right.
All
right.
Anyway, we're not going to get any help coming here. Not going to happen. Not going to happen. Not going to happen.
All right.
Okay, so in the farmhouse, how'd you rope and go this week?
Okay.
Okay, come on.
Oh, I need.
You need to quit playing with your food. Son, how did your roping go this weekend?
Went good.
Okay, that's not enough information for these people on the podcast. How did it go?
I got them lined up minus one. There's only one that's out of my color organization now. I just now figured that out.
You're right. Roping.
All right, I'm thinking.
You went Friday.
Yep. Didn't do any good.
Okay. Did you team rope or kip rope?
Both. I fell off my horse in the kip rope.
Wanted to step off. Did anybody get it in video?
Yes, we have that on video. And no, we're not showing it again.
Yes, we are. We will post that someplace. I will find a way to post that.
Let's see here. Then we went to another rodeo Saturday. I went second in the team roping.
Mm-hmm. You and your partner won second.
Yes. Then we went to a roping yesterday, and I didn't do anything.
But it's the one, it's a normal Sunday one that you work.
And then we need to talk mom and let me go to one day.
We need to get the sheep and the goats done. We're open. I can't be two places at once. And what's happened in the farmhouse? why are we having an issue with the truck? Because I can't like just let you get it, can I?
No.
Well, the alternator's out in the gold one. Uh-huh. And there's a reason we're referring to the gold one. It's Nellie. It's what I've always called her. She's been called that for 17 years. So, yes, we name everything, including Mom's truck, Nellie. Mm-hmm. And Nellie took her to, what, the fifth mechanic? Uh-huh. And what did he tell me?
She was dead.
She was dead. Everybody is impressed that I got 320,000 miles out of a gas engine. Okay, apparently this is unheard of. She's on her last leg, so we're gonna make her into a putter truck. Well, I was going to, but RJ putted around on her and the alternator went out. So what was Mom's resolution? What did Mom do?
She went and bought a new truck.
His name is Ollie, or her name is Ollie. So, tell us about Ollie.
He's a big truck.
She. I'm sorry, I don't drive boys. No. Tell him, what is it?
It's a 3/4 ton Chevy diesel.
So it's bigger than my truck.
Yes.
But not like a big 1 ton.
No. It's right in the middle.
Okay.
And it's a diesel.
What's my problem with getting feed and stuff?
It's a flatbed. We don't really have a problem. I mean, it'll do it.
I just have to learn to haul things on a flatbed. Because now I have to be very conscious of how it's stacked, don't I?
Mm-hmm. Before, I'm not throw anything in a truck bed.
I had my camper and the truck bed, and I just threw stuff in it, from lumber to sheep and goats to... You name it, it pretty much went in it, didn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Baby calves. I put hay in there one time and transported 3 baby calves back to my house in my truck. That truck has hauled... Nellie has hauled things that people never would have thought. From...
These Western are awful. Just an FYI.
No, they're not. They're veggie straws.
They're terrible.
They're the bomb.
They're a waste.
They all taste... Moose doesn't even eat them. Don't give them to him. He won't eat it.
Well, here, you eat it then. He licked it.
He did not. He doesn't like them. He smells them and he's done. Give him a finger off of it.
Oh,
okay, anyway, come on. Tell him about Ollie. What all have we hauled in Nellie is what we were talking about. The goats and sheep. The first goats came from West Virginia.
Uh-huh.
And we hauled... Leslie's from Texas hauled her sheep back in the trailer and our goats in the
truck.
Sienna and Cinnamon came back from Texas in the back of that truck.
Mm-hmm.
We had those Jersey calves that came from Western Oklahoma in the back of that truck. I got pictures of Chief being transported in that truck.
Mm-hmm. We've hauled everything in that truck, short story.
Yep. And we're not just talking in the trailer. We're talking actually in the bed of the truck.
Yep.
Wood, lumber, chickens. Anything else?
30 years later.
The question is more what we haven't hauled in that truck, huh?
40 years later.
Alright, so tell them about Ollie. Flatbed.
Yep.
My big problem with it.
It's a flatbed. And it's a Chevy. She's more upset about the flatbed than she is a Chevy car.
Honestly, I think the part I'm more upset about is the diesel part. What do I know about a diesel?
Nothing.
On Nellie, we did spark plugs, we could do the, everything. Right?
Yep.
The belts, the pulleys, the spark plugs, the works. Unfortunately, I don't know anything about a diesel. Other than their combustion to start to crank is totally different than
I gotta put diesel in it and drive it.
That's literally what I know. And I'm gonna have to start from scratch learning about my truck, yeah. Took me a week to find the cruise control, didn't it, son?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Did you know there's a recall out on some trucks? You set the cruise control and they just run off. They don't stop.
Wow. Gotta be a new one. Now, did we buy a brand new truck?
I wish.
We didn't. We got one. We pulled the Carfax on it. And it's been serviced pretty regular. And it's a 2005. So. Right?
Yep.
But I've been puttering around here in it and stuff, and it seems to do okay. Now, what's the big deal? Can I afford you on my insurance?
No.
Because of his medical issue while driving this summer, I can't afford to put him on the insurance because the insurance has to be full coverage. I dropped down. I had full coverage on Nelly in the car up until we got that truck. But I've got four vehicles that we are insuring. I have a fifth vehicle, but we don't insure it. All right, give them off, son. The five vehicles that we own, this is the same. None of them are brand new, but...
The 82.
We have an 82 Ford F-100 that was his grandpa's and his great-grandpa's. It's not tagged or anything. It's just for around here. Got Nelly, the gold truck.
Yep.
That everybody knows. New... white Ollie that everybody knows. And then what do we got?
Dad's car. And my car.
And RJ bought a truck. So that's five. I was keeping full coverage on everything. Do you know what that cost me with him on there? He's 20.
Probably a lot.
Too much. So we had to revamp the insurance. And anybody who's ever had a teen driver knows what that does to your insurance. And then if you have one who had a medical issue and passed out behind the wheel and had a wreck. That was another one, huh? So, the only good thing is that it's supposed to be expunged from his record because he stayed out of trouble for 6 months, right?
Yep.
He went over to the judge and he showed him that he wasn't drunk. He wasn't, like, they looked at, all of his accident report, his blood panel, his hospital stuff, they realized that it truly was an accident, not just kid messing around. There was guys in there, when he had to go talk to the DA, there was a man in there who couldn't lose his license for drinking because he was a truck driver. And if he lost his personal license, then they said they'd take his other license. But he was drinking. So, yeah, he was lumped in with people that really did stupid things instead of just having an accident. And the lady liked the fact that RJ took responsibility. He didn't ask her to get rid of the ticket. He said, the accident is legally my fault. I will pay what I need to pay and take care of it. But he asked her if it could stay off his insurance because it was a medical issue. And he was going to take steps to ensure that it wouldn't happen again. So, hence he quit his job over in Chelsea and now drives with someone. They said okay, and so it's supposed to stay on your insurance, correct? Which is a good deal. Anything else? Oh, hey, I gotta quit my thing I made for on the porch.
I'm not letting you out.
Yes, okay, then you have to get my skirt.
Okay, I'll let you out.
Then keep talking and tell right. What else has been going on here in the farmhouse.
Yep, mom's been working on stuff. I'll see you. She's been working some overtime. See here. What else has mom been doing? She made this deli whopper she went to go get. She mowed a bunch last night.
But I've been working at work because my boss had a wreck.
I just see you going at work.
Yep. Okay. Well, my boss had a wreck, so I've been helping out a little bit more. to take care of that family, and I've taken up her. Hubby is 81 and he doesn't cook, so I've been cooking and doing a little extra around there. But that's okay, she's home, she's safe, she's good. But what did I make? What did I make?
A Billy Whopper.
What is wrong with you?
Somebody woke me up an hour early. Because still it's donkey out.
Okay, you're not all that tired.
No, so, not really. I'm just bored. I've run out of things to fiddle with.
Okay, so I made
a Billy Whopper. A doohickey.
A
whatchamacallit.
You try it on and show them?
No. I draw the line.
Anyway, it's a frontier or, what do they call it? Patchwork skirt.
If you haven't noticed, I mean, all the patches.
Yep. So, it's my garden skirt is what I'm saying. And I was going to make it four-tiered, but what happened, son?
Got too long because you're short.
Yeah. Okay, so, when you put it here.
All right, here. Step forward.
Okay, you're ready. All right, so I wanted a four-tier, but the thing I was following is 10, and I have strings everywhere. I haven't trimmed any strings, but they're done with 10-inch squares, and if I did another 10 inches on there,
it is going to break the grain.
Yeah, pretty much. So this is all hemmed up, ready to go, other than trimming strings. I got a little carried away. I was making it with sleepy time, just. And then I just did a crochet, but I also can tuck this in through the inside if I don't want it seam. So this doesn't have to be seam. But and I just did it drawstring type. I didn't do elastic or anything, but there it is. And I kind of like it. I need to iron it. It got thrown in on the bed, and then it got thrown in on my floor when I went to bed. So I'll probably have to iron it and go over the strings, and it is ready to go. So I call it my garden skirt. I just think it looks like something I could wear in the garden.
Anybody else have a dog that just barks all the time for no apparent reason?
I know.
Moose does.
Moose. Oh my gosh, midnight last night, he just...
Think he has nightmares or something?
I don't know. No, because he does it when he's awake, too. So.
Maybe he has PTSD.
Yeah, post-traumatic doggy syndrome. Post-traumatic syndrome dog. I don't know.
PTDO. Or PTDO.
All right. Anything else?
Yeah.
Oh,
there's
that
thing.
One other thing.
Knew it.
And this is something I was working on earlier, but I had to rip out and start over. So.
Yeah, she's gonna rip it out in about 2 minutes, anyways.
No, I'm not. I already started over. Why would I rip it out?
Because you're not going to like it once you get going on it and you're going to decide to revamp it.
I actually am really liking it. Okay, so, move ahead. This is the side. This over here is going to be the armpit and this is going to be the side like this. And then it's going to be have the, and yes, I had half the front done. I did this, but it'll go here and then I'll have a thing that goes crossed here so that it's off the shoulder looking kind of thing. Anyway, so I started it again. My measurements were, I had it, the strap to start the shoulder was like over here. So, no, there's no pattern. I'm faking it and just making it.
Like everything else, too.
Pretty much. So, I just look at it, see what I want, and done. Alright, anything else?
No.
Have
we're
a good,
done.
Yep. Have a good Memorial Day weekend. I hope everybody's had a great one, enjoyed it. I'm going to go and see if I can't finish some mowing. The sheep and the goats work today. And...
Toodles.
RJ's upset that he can't go anywhere, but it is what it is, huh? So, anyway, all right, we'll see you later. We've said that already. Are you going to stop the camera?
Okay.
No, we're just going to keep going forever and ever.